Live from Media PA, it's News on the Lane. Good morning, I'm Irish G.
And I'm Lucia C., reporting from the Rosemary Angelina Broadcast Center.
Today is Tuesday, February 21st, 2023. It is day 7 of the 12-day cycle.
Our Pledge of Allegiance will be led by some Indian Lane students. Please stand, face the flag in your classroom, put your right hand over your heart to recite the pledge.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
Please join us in reciting the Bobcat Pledge.
We pledge to be ready, respectful, and responsible, all for a helping hand, be a friend to everyone, care about feelings, accept differences, have a little love, stand up for what is right.
Please be seated for some news and announcements. Today, the big story on the lane is that yesterday was President's Day.
President's Day is a holiday that occurs the third Monday of every February to celebrate our past and present U.S. presidents. We celebrate them because of their great contributions to the United States and to our democracy.
We have some birthdays to announce for this week. Take a look.
Happy birthday, everyone!
Today's main lunch is beef nachos, lettuce, tomatoes, cheese, pinto beans, fresh veggie of the day, and a choice of juice or fruit.
The alternate lunch choices are a peanut butter jelly sandwich, other assorted jelly sandwiches, or a salad.
We're doing a great job earning Bobcat brags. We now have this many brags. Check out our Bobcats who earned a brag yesterday.
Keep up the great work, Bobcats. We will earn our next school-wide reinforcer when we reach our goal of 500 Bobcat brags.
Okay, Bobcats, it is time to pick our winners for our Bobcat reinforcers for the week. We are going to do this live this week. We are doing it with the wheel, so let's get started. All of the names have been put in of everyone who received a Bobcat brag over the last week. So let's get started. Our first winner. Dominic Bradley. Congratulations, Dominic. Let's do our second winner. Bobby Clements, congratulations, Bobby, our second winner. And our third winner of the week. Jimmy Pappas. Winner number four. Sammy McNiff, Mason Weller, you are winner number 5. Who's it going to be? Who is our 6th winner this week? Kennedy DeLash. Only a few more to go. Winner number 7. Nick Gabrielli. Winner number 8. Sophia Schaeferman. 2 more to go. Who will number 9 be this week? Darla Chambers. And our last winner of the week. Here we go. Last winner. Bobby again? Okay, let's do one more. Let's do one more. Congrats, Bobby. You're having quite the week. Jimmy again. Woo! We're going to do one more. Let's get another winner here. There were lots of names I put in over on this side. Lots of names. Here we go. Lila. Lila Przewski. Congratulations. And these are our 10 winners of the week. Please make sure that you are having your teachers fill out which reinforcer you would like, and I will be around. I've been going around to classrooms. See everyone real soon.
February is Black History Month. If you have your quilt squares, please hand them in to your teacher today. Sketchbook Club meets today after school.
Reading Olympics meets tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. in the library.
And now, Ella F. is here with today's Believe It or Not fact. Ella, what do you have for us today?
Cyrus, today's fact is that in New Orleans, no one has school today. It's Mardi Gras, and people are at parades catching beads and other trinkets. Happy Mardi Gras! Back to you, Lucia.
Wow, Ella, you learn something new every day.
And now, here's David G. with today's special report. David, what do you have for us today?
Thanks, Iris. Today's special report is that Black History Month began as a week. In 1976, President Gerald Ford extended the week into a month so that Black Americans would be recognized throughout history for their many accomplishments in every area. Who have you learned about this month? Back to you, Lucia.
Thanks, David, for that special report.
For all crew members and special reporters, I'm Iris G.
And I'm Lucia C. Have a totally terrific Tuesday.